All right, this is a Frigidaire gallery heavy duty dryer which runs but it does not heat, and that's what I'm trying to troubleshoot today. So the very first thing naturally that you do it is take the power off, and immediately after disconnecting the power with the multimeter you have to check whether you are getting, first of all, in the port itself, whether you're getting proper 240 volt or not, 230 to 40 volt or not, between two points. You have to be careful not to touch it, between these two points, and between here and here you should get 120, and here you should get 110 to 120. 110 to 120 here, 110 to 120 here, 230 to 240 here. Because what happens is if you get only 110 to 120 volt, the dryer will run, but it will not heat. So that's the very first thing that I did. Once I found everything over there was all right, then what you have to do it is you have to pry this open. And for that, you can use a prying tool, or you can use one of the flathead. And just, you see, this is how it is hooked. So you just pry it a little bit and this whole thing comes off. And once this whole thing came off, then the next thing that I did was I again checked the voltage here. 110 to 120 here, 110 to 120 here, and then 230 to 240 here. Just making sure that voltage is still coming through.
All right, in this picture I'm showing a high limit thermostat, and as well as a thermal limiter, and also the power supply. Please notice the front as well as the back portion of the dryer.
So once you have confirmed that both these places you have the continuity, that means zero resistance, that means there's no problem there, right? Then you can come forward. Now here you would see there is a screw here, on you would see there is a screw on this side, left side, and there is one screw on the left and right hand side. So both these things you unscrew, and as soon as you unscrew them, then you can again use the same Phillips head, gently pry it around and all around, and you would see the cover would come up. Just two screws, that's what it is hung up on. And then naturally you have to take the cable out, this cable harness, disconnect it, and this whole board, this whole front should come off. And once you do that, this is how it looks like. So this is the front panel, this is the drum, this is the rest of the dryer. So
motor and the control thermostat below it, it's the one with the red and the black wire to it. So the control thermostat is tested exactly the same way. If for continuity, if the two terminals are showing zero resistance, that means there is a continuity and it's okay. Otherwise, it's faulty. And in my test, I realized that control thermostat was okay as well. So now when all the thermostats are right, then the only next thing that I could think of is the heating element itself. And the heating element is on the back of the dryer. So in order to reach the heating element, you have to first take the drum out. And for drum, taking the drum out, I needed to go to the back of the dryer, and there you would see a tiny little square shape opening with the two screws on it. So unscrew them and you have the access to the a small portion of the back of the dryer where you'd see the pulley and the wheel. So you have to loose the strings that tightens and rotates the drum, and once you loosen that up, then you can lift the drum and pull it out from the front. And this is how it looks once you pull the drum out. The coil, when in my case the coil was broken and it was not showing a 10 to 12 ohm resistance. A good coil, a good thermal element should show 10 to 12 ohm resistance. So I immediately knew that was the main reason why my dryer was not heating, and I needed to change the coil. For easy access to the coil, and especially if you want to replace it, the easier way to do it is take the entire thermal assembly out, and each thermal assembly, sorry, heating coil assembly is attached to the rear wall by four screws. You unscrew the four screws, and the whole heating coil assembly comes off, and then you can take the coil out. I found the coil on Amazon, the new coil on Amazon for $11.50. We'll include the link in this video.
Now we've packed everything back, and as it was, packing is exactly the opposite of unassembling, so it should not be a big deal, but I include the link as well. And I gave it a spin, and so far it seems to be running fine. One thing is, when it first starts, then it makes some creaking sound. That's because the belt is getting adjusted, so nothing to worry about that there. So I ran it for about 10 minutes, and just from the temperature, I can see that this is getting hot, so I'll let it run. So this is a little bit hot. That means it's the heater is working now. So that's it.